Well, thanks to Governor Healey. I so appreciated her remarks. So let me start my own remarks with a few essential thank yous. First, I have to say, in reading through today's program, I expect that we all had the same experience. Holy Toledo, this lineup is spectacular. The caliber of the speakers, the boldness of their thinking, the scale of their accomplishments, the range of frontier subjects being covered is just astounding. Sort of like a fantasy football team if biologists played football. In any case, I want to start by thanking the incredible team that persuaded all of these brilliant people to bend their calendars to make this day possible. Special shout out to our Dean of Science, Nergis Mavavala, to Dean of Engineering and Chief Innovation and Strategy Officer, Anantha Chandrakasan, to the entire Faculty Program Planning Committee, co-chaired by Professors Amy Keating and Katerina Rebeck, and especially to Marsha Warren and the events team, who orchestrated every detail. We're all in your debt for creating this extraordinary day. And of course, I want to thank all of our speakers from inside and outside of MIT for offering this amazing 14-course intellectual banquet. The talent assembled here, from those who'll speak to every one of you, has produced some truly towering accomplishments. But also, and I believe more importantly, you represent a deep well of creative potential for even greater impact. Which brings me to the insights that inspired MIT Heals. Since I still have fairly fresh eyes on the wonders of this multi-institutional community, let me start with a little perspective. So I started my career as a cell biologist and then a cancer biologist, and my husband, Danny Lev, also leads a research group here focused on pure curiosity-driven science. Well, we both had long, happy careers at another fine university, but I will never forget the expression on Danny's face the day I mentioned that I might interview for the president's job at MIT. MIT? You know, it was like those cartoon dogs, you know, where the eyes spin. He was thrilled, we both were, to think we might join a place with such a wall-to-wall appreciation for fundamental science. And you can imagine when we got here, like kids in a candy store. But pretty quickly, you realize it's not a candy store, it's a candy factory. Not only MIT, but the whole bioecosystem, from Kendall Square to the seaport, to the legendary hospitals and the countless corporations, startups, universities, venture capitalists, incubators, and philanthropists across the region. You see it any time you meet a clinician or a faculty member. Even students, they're exploring techniques or technologies right at the frontier of their fields. And then they casually tell you, oh yeah, I also started a company or two or more. As a source of new knowledge and new tools and new cures, and of the innovators and innovations that will shape the future of biomedicine and health, there is just no place like it. And today, we're here to talk about how we can make it even better. That is the ambition behind MIT Heals. Our goal with MIT Heals is to inspire, accelerate, and deliver solutions at scale to some of society's most urgent and intractable health challenges. So with that goal in mind, and with expert guidance and leadership from many of you here today, including Anantha and Nergis and many other faculty leaders, we've identified three priority areas where we have a vital opportunity to make a real difference. In shorthand, these three priorities are talent, collaborations, and bridges. First, talent. The caliber of talent in this room today is the caliber of talent that this ecosystem needs every day, forever. If we want to be the biotech capital of the world to spawn the next biotech revolution too, we can't take this concentration of talent for granted. But nothing attracts talent like talent. So a crucial part of MIT Heals will be finding ways to support, mentor, connect, and foster community for the very best minds at every stage of their careers. The second priority of MIT Heals is to spark new cross-cutting collaborations between individuals, both within MIT and with allies in the hospitals and industry, to encourage faculty to pursue high-risk, high-impact ideas, we're going to be providing substantial MIT funding. So why is this? Now, certainly, because daring, unproven ideas can often be the most transformative, but also because federal dollars are only shrinking. Federal funding seems to get more and more cautious all the time. I mean, I remember this frustration, and I'm sure many of you experience this frustration firsthand. To get a grant, sometimes people prefer you've actually finished or almost finished the work that you're proposing to do. This doesn't lead to transformative discoveries necessarily. I also want to emphasize that this internal funding will support not only translation, but deep, fundamental, curiosity-driven research. For people outside academia, it's very easy to see the value of translation. They see the cures that make it to the bedside. Yet for some outside of the scientific community, it can be a mystery why we care so much about basic research. But it is fundamental curiosity that has driven the discovery of so much of what we know and now take for granted in the life sciences. And I have to say, I always say this, even for those focused on translation, you can't translate nothing. You have to think about the fact that today's cutting-edge approaches, immunotherapy, AIDS therapy, the mRNA vaccines, the new sickle cell cure, thanks to things like CRISPR, things that were made, discoveries made based on just fundamental curiosity, all of them sprang from a robust pipeline of breakthrough knowledge. So we're investing enthusiastically to keep that pipeline strong. And of course, in terms of translation, we're eager to empower MIT's unique community at the juncture of engineering and bioscience in an era powered by incredible new tools. We want to give these faculty members the confidence to collaborate freely with colleagues from across disciplines, from AI, policy, and economics to the humanities to design. We want them to take on the hardest problems and pursue their biggest ideas. We see great potential for producing practical, scalable solutions in a wide variety of fields, such as AI and life science, low-cost diagnostics, neuroscience and mental health, environmental life science, food and agriculture, the future of public health and healthcare, and women's health. Third and finally, MIT HEALS will prioritize building bridges between institutions, developing even stronger, more effective relationships with the region's world-class hospitals and biotech and pharma industries. Several of our faculty, many faculty, have established very fruitful research programs with hospitals across the Charles. I think about the work of Regina Barsley and Jay Clinic as standout examples. But we want to make it much easier to make these relationships spring up and flourish. We want them to be in reach for everyone, so that each PI doesn't have to reinvent the process and re-navigate the same barriers around data sharing, computing power, and more. And at the same time, while MIT has always had a distinctive openness to working with industry, we believe that there is much more we can do to connect our researchers with the full power of the ecosystem, from biotech to pharma. You know, I have to say, I can speak from my own experience, even though it's receding into the distant past, working on basic science of a particular drug-resistant breast cancer. You know, we published a paper in Science Translational Medicine. We even patented our findings, but it felt absolutely impossible to take it further. We didn't have an ecosystem to plug into. Here, we definitely have the ecosystem. And MIT HEALS will help to very deliberately improve and deepen those connections too. Overall, MIT HEALS is an opportunity to make our work as individuals and institutions collectively add up to more than the sum of our parts. And I believe this effort could not be more timely or more important. A key next step will be selecting a faculty member to serve as a director, and a team of faculty from across the institute are conducting this search right now. In each of the areas I described, talent, collaborations between individuals, and bridges between institutions, we feel that action is imperative. And it gives me great pleasure to let you know that MIT HEALS has already attracted major support from several sources. For instance, in the area of talent, an important aspect of MIT HEALS is supporting our graduate students to explore new directions in life science, particularly interdisciplinary research. I'm pleased that MIT will be able to provide new internal support for an initial cohort of graduate fellows for MIT HEALS, and we're delighted that the founder and CEO of Flagship Pioneering, Nubara Fayyan, who's here today, one of our longtime collaborators, a member of the executive committee and of the MIT Corporation, and a former MIT Course 10 PhD student himself, has committed to supporting additional graduate fellowships as part of MIT HEALS. So thank you, Nubara. In the same spirit of supporting great talent, and as another key part of MIT HEALS, we will launch the MIT Health and Life Sciences Collaborative Fellows Program, a world-class program for postdoctoral scholars. This highly competitive program will give fellows the freedom to explore some of the most pressing issues in life science and human health. Fellows will receive a four-year fully funded appointment at MIT and benefit from faculty mentorship as well as participation in community events focused on careers in academia, industry, and entrepreneurship. We are delighted to announce a gift from the Biswas Family Foundation to establish the inaugural cohort of postdoctoral fellows. The Biswas Fellows will conduct cross-cutting research in areas such as AI computation and health, low-cost diagnostics, nanoscale therapeutics, neuroscience, women's health, and curiosity-driven life sciences. Thank you so much to the Biswas Family Foundation. As an example of sparking new collaborations, I'm also thrilled to announce another integral piece of MIT HEALS, the new Hood Pediatric Innovation Hub. It was established through a catalytic gift from the Charles H. Hood Foundation, a leader in supporting groundbreaking and innovative pediatric research. Led by Professor Elazar Edelman, the Edward J. Poitras Professor in Medical Engineering and Science, and a world-renowned cardiologist, the Hub will bridge the translational gap for innovations in pediatrics. Currently, the major market incentives are medical innovations intended for adults. As one example, children are often treated with medical devices and therapies that don't meet their needs because they're simply scaled-down versions of the adult models. The Hood Pediatric Innovation Hub aims to overcome such persistent barriers to bringing life-saving technologies to market by leveraging MIT's state-of-the-art technological expertise and a network of healthcare stakeholders across the country. It will also strengthen collaborations with many hospitals, including with an important partner in Boston Children's Hospital. So, huge thanks to the Hood Foundation. And finally, I'm excited to share that one of the flagship components of MIT HEALS will be a collaboration framework between MIT and Mass General Brigham. It will bring together these two world-class research institutions to advance technology and clinical research for transformative changes in patient care. Through the MIT MGB Seed Program, we will seek, garnering and will continue to seek philanthropic funding to establish seed grants for joint research projects led by MIT and MGB researchers in mutual areas of interest. And I'm extremely pleased to announce that Analog Devices will help launch the MIT MGB Seed Program with gifts to both MIT and MGB to establish the Analog Devices, Inc. Fund for Health and Life Sciences. This visionary gift, which has been described by Analog CEO Vince Roche as a once-in-a-generation opportunity, will help accelerate the adoption of critical sensing, digital, and AI technologies in clinical settings. And the new framework overall will be a model for how we can all work together more effectively in the future. So thank you to MGB, and thank you to Analog Devices. So this is fantastic. I mean, you can see there's fuel, energy, power behind this. We have very high hopes for MIT HEALS, and the momentum is already beginning to make these aspirations real. Now, before I close, I have to particularly call out the Dean of Engineering and Chief Innovation and Strategy Officer, Anantha Chandrakasan, who has had the vision and drive behind bringing this initiative to life. So I really want to thank you again, Anantha. And to all of you, I'm so grateful that you've joined us for this important moment, for this outstanding program. Look forward to working with all of you as we work to seek new knowledge, bold new solutions to real problems in human health in fields from cancer to climate change. So thank you all, and I hope everyone enjoys the day.